Good evening, my friends. And welcome back to another episode of Assassin's Creed 2. Remember from last episode, we kind of ended at a point. Blacksmiths. Cool. We kind of like ended at a point where we had to deliver some sort of letter. Shit, that was close. And yeah, so we're gonna start off the game today by delivering that letter, or instead, let's just what the fuck? Excuse me, goddamn. Let's go activate this watchtower here. Might as well, right? I'd say so. Map out some of the world here. Hello there, Eagle. And let's synchronize. Ooh, yeah, baby. There's like a little river in the middle. Alright, ooh, we're pretty much there. No way did I, like, make that bullshit. Whatever. I'm okay with it. Tailors. I guess they make me clothes or something. Cool. Alright. Hello there, dude.
Ah, Ezio. Ben trovato. How are you? Come sempre. I have a letter for Messer Lorenzo.
I'll see that he receives it when he returns.
Returns?
They've gone to Villa Careggi, I'm afraid. And not expected back for at least another day.
I'll let my father know.
Return to Giovanni. Giovanni. Alrighty. Good deal, I suppose. Let's make my way back then. Okay, come on, game. Oh, that might hurt. Oh, it didn't. Good. I had expected it to. A message of content. Get out of my way. Alrighty. That guy just called me a pagan? I swear he did. Okay, is there like a door to go into, or? Ah, yeah, okay.
Keep up the good work,
biscero.
Okay, where the hell?
You worry too much, Giovanni. Francesco Di Pazzi is in prison. The threat is ended.
Oh, hey. Did you notice this dude? Did you notice this loot here? There was coins in there, dude. Whatever.
Hello, son. You remember my friend Uber?
Good morning, Gonfaloniere Alberti.
To you as well, young man. I trust you delivered the message.
Si, padre. But it seems Lorenzo is out of town.
I did not anticipate this.
What does it matter? So you wait another day or two.
Listen, your mother and sister have been looking for you. I'll need you again in a little while, but for now, see if you can't help them.
Are you sure?
Yes, now if you'll excuse us.
Good to see you, Ezio.
Paperboy. Alright, looks like there's a few people. Courier assignments. So I can be a paperboy. Maria Auditori. I grew tired of these walls that surround me and am bored with safety. Now is the time to make a decision. I will go out there and see what my life may truly be. Maria wrote those words when she was 16, a week before she met Giovanni Auditore. Born into the powerful banking family, the Mosi, Maria is one of the most famous historical sources of the time period due to her multi-volume diary, which has been translated by several notable scholars and is on display in the Uffizi Gallery in Florence. Whew! With funding from her parents, Maria opened up a bakery in the courtyard of the family palazzo, which she transformed into an artistic gathering place. It was there that she met a man with such conviction I found myself rooted to the spot, unable to look anywhere else. That man was Giovanni Auditore. Maria and Giovanni were married in 1450. Maria's diary entries continue for the next few decades, describing her patronage of several up-and-coming artists and her trials as a mother, at which point she abruptly abandons her writing to a disappointment of historians everywhere. People just rage at that type of shit. Press that button to access the map. It doesn't tell you, that's kind of annoying. Use the map to locate objectives and side quests. You can also set your own GPS marker in the Animus Desktop's map folder. Speak.
Buongiorno, Ezio.
Buongiorno a voi, madre. Come state?
Sto bene. And you? Still recovering from last night?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Of course not. Anyway, I have an errand to run. I'd like you to join me.
Con piacere.
Come. It's not far from here.
Help Maria with her errand. I'm a friend of the family. Alright, she's got a life bar.
I know about your fight with Vieri.
Do you know about my sex with Christina?
Per piacere. Let's not play this game.
Yeah, seriously, we'll fight.
He spoke ill of us. I could not allow him to continue.
I'm sure he's having a hard time dealing with the accusations against his father. Francesco di Pazzi is many things, and none of them good. But even I never suspected he'd be capable of murder.
What happened to him?
I imagine there will be a trial.
Will father speak at it?
He'll have to. He's the one with the evidence.
Still, I wish there was another way.
You've nothing to fear. Everyone wants justice done. It is an unfortunate state of affairs, but it will pass.
Cool. Banks. It looks like the Templars are using the banking network to transport their money. I bet you could snag some of that cash. With the advent of double entry bookkeeping, which allowed bankers to keep track of their clients' deposits and withdrawals, and the proliferation of many different types of Italian currency into the pool of circulation, banks became an essential part of everyday Renaissance life. Banks technically couldn't make money on their money, because the Catholic Church forbade the charging of interest. But in practice, this restriction wasn't followed by bankers or even by the Vatican, which participated in the banking system required banks to pay the Pope's gifts in proportion to the amount of money he had deposited with them. As long as it isn't called interest, God won't notice, right? I guess so. Where the fuck are we going? What does this one say? Bottega di Leonardo a Firenze. Leonardo da Vinci opened his own studio after completing his apprenticeship to Verrocchio, one of the most successful Florentine artists of the day. In 1476 and 1481, Leonardo probably continued to collaborate with Verrocchio, although no one is quite sure what he was working on. In 1481, he was given his first commission by the monks of San Donato, a Scopetto, to paint the Adoration of Magi. In true Da Vinci style, he began the painting, but never finished it. That sucks.
Here we are.
We're here. The fuck is this place? Hello?
Hello, Leonardo.
Oh, Donna shit.
Maria.
This is my son, Ezio.
Molto onorato. L'onore è mio. Let me go and fetch the paintings. I'll be right back.
He's very talented.
Imagino.
Self-expression is vital to understanding and enjoying life. You should find an outlet.
I have plenty of outlets.
I meant besides vaginas.
Whoa.
Mother. Back to your house, then.
Si, si. Ezio, help Leonardo, will you?
What am I helping him with? Leonardo da Vinci. Let's read about him. Born 1452. Profession. He's a painter, inventor, designer, architect, scientist, and engineer. Damn, man of many talents. He'd fucking win the Jack of All Trades achievement in this game. The illegitimate son of a notary and a peasant woman, Leonardo da Vinci was raised in Tuscany. Like many destined to be superstars, he had no surname. Vinci began being the town he was born. At age 14, he was apprenticed to a Florentine painter, Verrocchio, who taught him chemistry, drafting, painting, sculpting, and modeling. When he was 20, Leonardo established his own workshop and then traveled across Italy, eventually painting his great masterpieces, The Last Supper in 1498 and the Mona Lisa in 1503 to 1507. During his travels, Leonardo studied the world with unquenchable curiosity, recording his observations in mere writing within his notebooks. He created designs for a helicopter, tanks, solar power, and a calculator, among others. He was also an engineer, designing garrisons, cannons, and movable barricades. Despite this epic list of accomplishments, Leonardo was hounded by his patrons for his chronic procrastination. Pieces frequently took years longer than he anticipated, and many were never finished at all. Leonardo also had a tumultuous love life, accused of sodomy. In 1476, he was most likely homosexual. Soleil, his assistant, was accused of stealing and spending too much money on clothes, but was also probably Leonardo's lover. Leonardo painted several pictures of Soleil, including his famous Saint John the Baptist, and left the Mona Lisa to him when he died in 1519. All right.
What do you do?
He's been working for his father.
Ah, you're to be a banker. For now. And you, Art, was it? Truth be told, it's been difficult for me to settle. Painting is nice, but I often feel like my work lacks, I don't know, a purpose. Does that make sense? I'd rather contribute more practically, more directly. Architecture, perhaps, or anatomy. I'm not content merely to capture the world. I want to change it.
Oh, Leonardo. I have no doubt you'll go on to do great things.
Vi ringrazio, Madonna. That's kind of you.
Yes, it's very kind of you. Are they seriously, like, raising their arms at me? Fucking assholes. Alrighty.
Thank you for your help, son. Don't let me keep you from your other duties.
Ooh.
It was nice to meet you, Ezio. I hope our paths cross again. Anch'io.
Alright. Checkpoint reached. Oh yeah, I've synced that one. Oh yeah. Claudia Auditori. Let's read about you. 1461, she's a student noble. The third child of Giovanni and Maria Auditori, and the first girl in the family. Claudia seems to have been a bit of a spoiled brat. Looks like her parents had to raise her dowry by 1,000 florins after she scared away all her potential suitors. A report from her school indicates she once attacked another girl for looking at her boyfriend and knocked her out cold. The plus side, she's Ezio's sisters. So you should be safe. Excellent.
Hey, Claudia. How are you?
Bene.
You shouldn't keep things from me.
It's Duccio.
What of him?
I think he's been unfaithful.
Who told you this?
The other girls. I thought they were my friends.
Harpies. You're better off without them.
I loved him.
No, Claudia. You only thought you did.
He should suffer for what he's done.
Wait here. I'll go have a word with him.
Wow. She's very cruel. Beat a cheat. Find and punish Duccio. Don't mind if I do. I will go punish the fuck out of him in ways you could never imagine. Oh yeah, I will. Just be prepared. God damn, there's so many people walking around here. You better be fucking sorry. Shit. Alrighty, let's read this as I fall. Santa Maria del Fiore, one of Italy's largest churches and the largest landmark in Florence. Santa Maria del Fiore is considered by many to be the first masterpiece of Renaissance architecture. While the church was designed by Arnolfo di Cambio in 1296, the dome was not started until the beginning of the 15th century. With Cambio long dead, none of the architects at that time had any idea how to construct such an enormous structure. Since the use of buttresses was forbidden in Florence and mortar took several days to set, but all was not lost. In an amazing comeback story, Filippo Brunelleschi, an architect who had been defeated in an earlier bid to design the baptistry doors, won the competition to build the dome. He beat out Lorenzo Ghiberti, the same artist he had lost to before. Brunel, invented machines to hoist the bricks needed for the dome up to the workers and was able to construct the entire dome without using centering, which is a support structure to hold the dome in place while bricks were laid. Containing over 4 million bricks, the dome was completed in 1436. Lantern was added after Brunel's death in 1446. It supposedly contained holy relics. However, there were several rumors that, in fact, an entire tomb of unknown origin is located inside. Coolio. Okay, I see a... I guess it's up here? Well, shit, I'm gonna try and climb it if I can find, like, a way. Oh, shit. Oh, no. What have I done? I'm so sorry. How the hell am I gonna climb that? There's, like, no way. Oh, here we go. There we go. Yeah. That is fucking high. I ain't gonna be able to climb that very easily, ain't I? Hell no, that. I'll climb up here, though. I'll take a gander at that. Holy fuck, dude, I can't even see the top of that. That's so damn high. Alright. Whoa! Okay.
Duccio, it's beautiful.
Nothing but the
Why the hell do you want to have her? Or my sister?
Claudia. I thought you'd been promised to her.
Your father said I could do much better than an auditore.
Ah, Birbante! Come, let us walk a bit.
What? I had something else in mind.
Oh, Duccio.
Yep,
hey,
caught him.
Lurido porco! Ezio, my friend.
You insult my sister, parading around with his puttana.
What are you talking about?
I saw the gift you gave her. Heard the things you said.
Maybe your sister shouldn't be so stingy with her virtù.
You broke her heart.
Ha! And now I'm going to break your face.
Oh! I'm ready to kick some ass. Beat up Duccio.
Ha! You'll regret ever opening your mouth.
I could have taught your sister a great many things. She's lucky to have had someone like
Bastardo!
Yeah, stay on the ground, bitch.
Stay away from my sister.
I think he kind of was. Beat up episodes are available. Yay, now I'm able to beat up random people. Beat a cheat. Yeah, I don't understand how the hell you would even go about climbing that. That is so high. So would we be able to like climb here or somewhere? Oh, let's try here. See if we can climb all the way to the top. Okay. Let's go up to the corner here. Ah, yes. Alright. Well, let's go for it. Ooh, sick. I'm gonna climb all the way up to the top. I'm gonna do it. Ooh, there's shit in there. There's like a piece of treasure. I want it. Okay, is it? Oh, it's much higher. Shit. How am I gonna do this? How am I gonna get up there? I'm already really high, and if I fall, I'm gonna totally die. yeah. It's gotta be on this side, right? Oh, yep, there's something here I can do. Good, 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 good. Oh, yes, keep going. Yeah. It's in this room. Even more goodies. Found some serious secret shit here. Some more coins. Okay, let's, I'm not gonna risk going down and shit. It's too dangerous. Let's, actually, we can probably climb inside here, right? And get somewhere. Oh, yep. Ooh, that was a good one. Would I even be able to, like, get out? Oh, maybe. Wow, this is a really high place. I wouldn't want to be climbing in here. That was risky as hell. Okay. I'm basically at the throat of the world. Okay. That's probably the throat of the world. That looks higher. But this is an amazing view. It's insane. Wow. Okay. Looks unfinished too. Like they could like make it taller if they wanted to. No, he totally missed that. That was a miss. God, that was risky. Would not do that even if my dick was gonna be cut off if I didn't. I'd let my dick be cut off. I don't give a shit about my dick. Fuck it. I'm not jumping off that. Even if there's a nice haystack.
Hey, Ezio!
Hey, who are you? Petrusio. Let's learn about you. 1463, the youngest of the auditory children. Petrusio was described as having a weak constitution by Giovanni Auditori in a letter to Lorenzo de Medici soon after the boy's birth. Oh, that's a boy? Oh, shit. Okay. Apparently, he didn't improve with time. Petrusio was pulled from school due to illness when he was 12, and according to records from the family doctor, was confined to bed. No other data exists after that, so it is probable that he eventually succumbed to his illness. But he's still alive. That means he's less than 12 years old.
What are you doing out here, Petruccio? You should be in bed.
I want those feathers.
It's like what for? Daytime as fuck.
It's a secret.
If I get them for you, will you go back inside?
Yes, I promise.
Petruccio's signal, or secret. Obtain the eagle feathers before he gets in trouble for sneaking out of bed. Why is he in bed? Is it nap time or is it nighttime? Because there's no way it's nighttime. Oh, there's more. Oh, shit. Oh, I'm timed as fuck. Okay. Well then. Oh. Tickle. So he wants, like, a lot of eagle feathers then? Well, you gave me more than enough time to do this. That time went away, so I'm gonna go grab this Eagle Vision eyeball. Okay. There we go. Alright, let's take a look at the world. Oh wow, I can see where the memory ends. Alright, awesome. I think there's just like a bunch of bird nests everywhere. It looks pretty. Oh, you're a doctor. I was about to say, who the hell are you? You're all glowing and shit. I gotta knock on my own door.
Here, as promised.
Grazie, brother.
You still haven't told me why you want these.
I will. In time.
In time. Definitely looks older than 12. Feather locations unlocked. What is this? Feathers can now be collected throughout the world. Why would I want to do that? You want something?
Get this to its destination fast. Really fast. I'll pay you well.
Oh, you'll pay me. Casanova. Okay. Let's deliver some letters. I don't. From Raphael on. Oh, I can actually read the letter. My dearest, how can I live without you? I cannot work. I simply idle away, dreaming of your face. The fact that your father has locked you away behind cold walls sickens me. You are a budding young woman. You should have the privilege to feel my sweet kisses like a gentle wind caressing your soft petals. Yet finally it is Friday when he goes off to market on happy day and still happier night. Come, when the sky rains with sparkling stars. Come find me and jump into my arms. At dusk, we'll be waiting at our special spot. Yours forever, Raphael. Oh, I'm timed here. Okay. Oh shit. No. Fuck me.
Stop me.
No. That was an accident, I promise. Oh, I'm glad I climbed up here. I did it for good reason. Okay, I'm having trouble. Become anonymous. Okay, we're gonna have to kill these people. Sorry I'm beating up these people on your porch. I hope you get framed for it. You're welcome, I suppose. Alright, I took your money. She didn't care, though, which is good. People I rob from don't care either. I'm just joking. I can't believe all those people have, like, are on high alert to come kill me. Jeez. It's like they paid the guards a lot of money to try and come after me. It's kind of sad and pathetic. Wait, did you really send the same letter to both these chicks? Damn, he's got two pussies. One of them's really old. Okay. Alright, let's activate this one right here. Oops. Shit. No, what the hell's going on? Let me up there. Thank you. Okay, let's see if I can climb it. Yeah, do that. Yeah. Much better. So look at the world. There's the edge of the planet. Edge of the planet. That's a good one. Alright, what side quests do we have? We got like any of them? What does this mean? That's Taylor. Okay. Beat up event. Let's set a marker at that beat up event. Let's do a beat 'em up challenge. Okay, I like ragdolled the shit out of that place. You're desynchronized. Let's fix that. It was never supposed to die. The beat up event, like, right here? No, what else is the beat up event? Okay, I've already read this one.
No fancy prices here, just but.
Alright. Let's go. The banks. I wonder if you die, you actually lose currency. If this is like one of those games, you know? Well, I'll find out in time. I have 1490 florins. I forget what the currency was called before it was florins, like denario or something like that. I know it was something in Spartacus.
That faithless husband of mine is cheating. I know it, as do all the neighbors. Please teach him a lesson for me.
Oh, don't mind if I do. Just trust a complete stranger to beat up your husband. Might as well, right? I'm basically like an assassin. Oh, that's exactly what I am. Shit. Well, it doesn't seem that I'm an assassin yet. I don't know if he even knows that his family's an assassin yet, or if Giovanni knows. I mean, we're not an assassin yet, but something's bound to happen that's gonna cause us to become assassins. Oh yeah, I got an eagle vision this game. Okay, it's E button, right? No, it's E. Oh, there it goes. So I go find this faithless husband. Alright, where's he? Ah! You faithless husband.
I can't die! I'm
hey, hands off!
Ah. Oh, I didn't kill him.
Donato! She wins! I give up! That bitch! I mean, wonderful wife of mine! I'll go home!
Okie dokie then, dude. And she gave me money for that. Okie dokie then. Go check out the viewpoint here. Might as well. Okay, it's way the hell up there. I can handle that. Yeah, drop your broom. They're gonna catch me. Yep. They sure did. Yeah, I'm right here, dudes. I'm right here. Let's synchronize. Cool. I updated my map. Let's see if anything pops up. There's nothing really to really update on the map. Yes. Okay, go to that viewpoint now. Guess we'll do that next, before we continue on with the missions. I'm basically gonna try and like 100% this game. I guess I'm gonna like try and find all the eagle things as well. Which I'm not sure. I know in Brotherhood, like, kind of tells you whenever you find a viewpoint where some of the stuff is. What's this bag doing here? Is it, like, really nothing? That sucks. Alright, there's a viewpoint there, but I guess I can't get to it because it wasn't on the map. So I'm assuming I can't get to it. Maybe totes wrong, though. But you never know. I might be totes wrong.